next guest is a familiar face to Aussies, but she truly lives on the world stage. Have a look.
She's the global movie star with a background to match. Greta Scacchi was born in Italy, but spent time growing up in Britain and Australia. A truly unique actor, fluent in English, French and Italian, she shot to worldwide fame in 1983 as the sultry femme fatale in Heat and Dust, then followed it up with White Mischief.
How'd you do?
A host of Hollywood roles followed, including Robert Altman's The Player with Tim Robbins and Presumed Innocent with Harrison Ford.
How can you think that I can do a thing like that?
She received Italy's equivalent of a knighthood for services to the arts and is now back home as an ambassador for the Italian Film Festival.
Please welcome Greta Scacchi to Studio 10! To our crazy little morning show.
You've all got coffees.
Oh, sorry, did anyone get you one?
That's just stunt coffees.
Okay.
We are all so excited. Everyone's been so nervous and excited because you're like a real proper big movie star.
Oh, am I?
Yes,
I'm back at those films as well. Harrison Ford, was he even cranky back then? Because we've heard he's very cranky.
No, he's shy.
Is he?
Yes.
Sure. Very sweet. Oh, really?
Mm. Oh, my God. I'm just kind of a fangirl. I'm like, oh, my God. You know, I loved you in White Mischief and in The Player.
Yep.
Oh, my God. And what's the one I love? Remember when you were in Emma?
Yes. No, I can't remember.
Oh, my God, you were so good in that. Oh, sorry. Okay, now I'm done.
And that's it. We're out of questions.
Sorry.
What was it? I mean, you are still, of course, a Hollywood royalty, but you were just so huge in the 80s and 90s. What was it like being a movie star back then? What was Hollywood like?
I didn't like it very much. That's why I came away. I'd always wanted to work in theatre. And I also, when I found that they wanted me for film roles, it facilitated my travel to my favourite places in the world, places I felt like at home. Mm-hmm. You know, England and the rest of Europe, particularly Italy. I worked a bit in France and Germany. And I got to have my flights paid to Australia to come back home and, you know, do a film or do a play. I've done a lot of theatre in Australia. But I found that America didn't suit me. So
you've always been very...
you didn't sort of really like America so much. Was it... you turned down Basic Instinct, is that right?
Yeah, that was just because I didn't like the script.
There was a lot about, I think, how they sort of portrayed women in America, would you say, that you didn't like?
Yeah, I think she was, that character was the kind of last big male fantasy character. Mm. And in the 90s and the noughties, I think women have managed to really blaze a trail. I mean, we're always pioneers of our age and you kind of do the best you can within the limitations of that time. And there's still a long way to go for women, but I think that their voice is starting to be heard and expressed and we're being allowed to be women. The only trouble is that the wonderful roles that there are now for women, I'm asked to play the mother or the grandmother.
But you do that so beautifully.
Oh, thank you very
much. You would. Because your voice, you have the most gorgeous speaking voice.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it is. It's very round and resonant. But you also speak a number of languages.
Mm, including Australian.
Because you're here for the Italian Film Festival.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, so I'm half Italian and half Australian.
Australian. Which
half
much.
English as well.
That's right. I was going to say, because you've always been very, I suppose, non-Hollywood. You're very cosmopolitan. You're a citizen of the world. You're half Italian, half Australian, half English, half everything else. Does speaking a lot of different languages, does it help you understand things better? Like, do you value that more than other stuff? Or is it just something you know how to do?
Yes, I mean, one thing that I find with having grown up with Italian in my ears is that it really helps you speak English better because without having to have been an Oxford scholar, you know, I've got a lot of hints in the words that come from Latin. Mm. You know, I kind of understand a lot of sophisticated English words.
Are you good at doing crosswords?
I sound more educated than I am. I'm very good at crosswords.
I thought you might be.
Yeah.
Now, Greta, you have been awarded the equivalent of a knighthood in Italy.
Yes, Cavaliere.
And, yeah, I wasn't going to even try and pronounce it. And you're out here for the Italian Film Festival. In fact, there's great buzz. It starts today. There's great buzz about a film called Tenderness.
La Tenerezza, yes. Gianni Amelio directed it, and I always loved his work and dreamed of working with him. He did L'America, Stolen Children, The Keys of the House, Open Doors, a lot of the... I mean, he's just one of the most dignified living directors in Italy. And he approached me to play a part. It's a small part, but it's a monologue where I get to really twist the plot at that point, about three quarters of the way through the story. And, oh, you're showing some of it.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
We're very professional that way.
She's a right old bag of a character. She's really mean. She's a failed mother.
Oh, a failed mother?
A mother who didn't connect with her son.
Well, you have connected with your children, but they've left home now. How has your life changed? Have you thrown yourself back into your career? Well, how has it changed?
It has changed quite dramatically. I mean, I wouldn't want you to let my children know, but, you know, once you get over the tears of, you know, the empty nest, you suddenly realise that you're free! And you can go anywhere!
Yeah.
And you don't have to constantly worry about other people's needs before your own. And I found it very liberating, yes. I must say. Mm. But please don't tell them.
No.
You were saying before that you hated the hype of Hollywood. Mm. So when your beautiful daughter, Layla, is dating someone as... like Sean Penn, do you give her advice on how to navigate that, or do you wish you could just steal her back to Australia and protect her, or are you...
Do you have children?
I have one. He's two.
He's two. Okay, so you don't know yet about trying to give advice to your children.
just let it play.
Don't even try.
The opposite.
Just zip, okay? It's the only thing you can do. But Layla is, you know, she's half Italian, half Australian, half English, and half American as well. So, or quarter American, let's say. So it's not that, by the way, we said earlier that I didn't like America. That's not true. It's a vast and varied, fascinating place. And when you get there and get to know and get to travel, it's so different from what you expect for America, because it's actually really quite... backward in a lot of places, in a lot of ways. You know, you wouldn't think that because it seems so technologically advanced. But I mean, there are backwaters, there are regions that are so isolated.
Very parochial.
It's really as vast as and a lot of it as empty as Australia is. But I feel more backward than Australia in a way. You know, I find people are much more tuned in here, and certainly when you're in LA, it's what I don't like in Hollywood is that it's very in-looking. People are very vain, and they're all living in a community, wanting to work in film, and so the what's happening in film and what are the latest releases are the big news, and world news and real life starts to lose its significance, and I find that very. Very limiting and very and dangerously seductive, you know. So I don't want to stay there for too long because you know you feel like you'd grow donkey ears like Pinocchio.
Oh, you're so profound.
We could chat to you all day. You're just such a generous person and a wonderful woman and a great actress. Thank you so much for stopping by. Italian Film Festival runs in Sydney from today until October 8 and across various dates nationally. For more info, you can head to italianfilmfestival.com.au. Greta, thank you so much for stopping by.